Is it filming?
Yeah.
Let's go.
So.
I'm Alistair, 19, French.
My name is Samba, I'm 21 years old. I'm from the Gambia, West Africa.
My name is Francesco. I originally come from Italy.
My name is Adrian, I'm French.
Well, I'm Arthur De Moubray, I'm 19. I was born in France from a French mum, English dad.
My name is Eugenio Goya. I'm 18, almost 19. I'm from Italy, from Torino.
Okay, I'm Miliko Jaktan, the Turk from Luxembourg. I'm the only Muslim on the team.
Hi, my name is Caleb Bihoning, and I play for the Plein FC. I'm from Ethiopia.
I'm Nicholas, 21 years old, from France, as you can see.
I am Elias Basquin, from France and Germany, and I now play for the Plein FC.
I'm Juan, from Colombia. I'm the center back for the Plein.
So, hi, my name is Kate. I'm Japanese Slovenian. Grew up in Vienna. I love to play football.
I'm Sam Mara. I play number 6, CDM for the Plein.
Hello, I'm Elias. I'm 21, from Berlin, Germany.
Hi, my name is Abba. I'm a player of the Plein FC.
I'm Gabo. Basically, I'm Italian. I'm 19.
I'm Seb Wright. It's my shirt. Striker. English.
Perfect. Hello, guys. I'm Paolo Masiello. And I'm a student. I'm 19. And I'm Italian.
The Plein is more than just like a football club.
The Plein is more than a club. It's a mentality.
It's like what going to church was back in the old days, you know? It's you do it weekly. It's great.
The Plein is a university club. We're just like a bunch of homies. We all just gather up and play footy.
It's a football team full of friends. Yeah.
What's your favorite thing about the Plein?
Play football.
Well, being playing
dissecting playing
football like with friends, you know, like
he's interesting.
The Plein is an amazing group formed by the captain Arthur.
It's a student team based in The Hague, full of students from both the Hoger School and Leiden, which are the both universities in The Hague. And it was basically created because we were basically last August in our student housing trying to look for things to do, and we decided to go out play football, and from like we then did it again the next day, and like from that point we were like, let's start creating a team. So we went to the tryouts of the club, which was already existing, HVV Football Factory, and we basically like stuck together and decided to form a team inside this club, and so that's how the Plein was born.
My favorite thing is like the casual vibe. Everyone's always in a good mood.
Oh well, it's brilliant at uni. You know, it's one of the top things to do here.
Well, let's say without the Plein, I wouldn't have no friends in the Hague. So you know, through football.
And well, I love this team. I love this team spirit.
Yeah, friends come together, have fun on the pitch. Have fun off the pitch, and that's where the magic happens, you know, on and off the pitch.
What kind of magic happens off the pitch?
Off the pitch, I don't know if I can get into details, but a lot of things happen, you know. It's like, we have a good time, that's all I'm gonna say.
I feel like we're all bros, and not only do we play together and train together, but also we go out together, we spend a lot of time together doing all sorts of different things, and so it really feels like a family.
It's fun, it's easy to go. I just like it a lot because even if you're not a big football guy, have a big football background, you can still go there, have fun, improve.
And the people are the best part because there are different students from different parts of the world.
Hello International. Love to see it. It's just a mix of everyone, you know, different skills, different like, you know, attributes. And it's funny, like, cause like people from the same countries like play a certain way, you know, I don't know, like
I was gonna say Japanese, but I don't know why other Japanese people play football besides skate.
It's actually like the fun part. Like, it's just not only about sport. It's about meeting new people, learning about new cultures.
My favorite thing about the Plein, I think, like the close relationship you can have with every single player.
How do you think the Plein will do this year in the league?
Okay, so the goal is to get first, okay. But I think, let's say fourth.
Out of 12, first.
We're gonna win this.
This season, we're gonna win the title.
You know, finish first, obviously, finish best.
Top five.
I think we'll do well.
Maybe, hopefully, the fifth place, the sixth.
I say fourth.
Champions League.
Champions League. Europa League, worst case, but we're not touching the Conference League this year.
I don't think we're gonna finish last. I mean, touch wood on that, but I think around 6th, 7th.
What league are we playing in?
Don't know.
We're playing this on with the 7th amateur division in South Holland. Yeah, I think if we can stay up and we don't get relegated, that's a great result for the season.
We haven't really started anything. We're just trying to win them. Okay. Just trying to fucking, you know, just trying to slap some goals. I reckon, like, you know, not even winning, just a couple goals. I'm fine with it. If we can score and celebrate, it's perfect. I'd love to like celebrate, you know, cheeky goals. The salmon a bit.
Bro, we are gonna be the champion, man. I think we could be actually the champion. We are playing actually like the lowest division, so if we don't win the cup, bro, then we just need to stop playing football.
Yeah, fighting for, like, I'd say it's finishing 6th out of 12 would be good to be in the first part of the league.
But if the squad were to remain the way it is right now and everybody showed up to practice more or less, I think we would manage to end up around midfield of the league.
Because this is something that we've created, and so that sense of the fact that we get to do this off our own backs is a really nice feeling, and we've all taken on different roles in the team.
I'm the captain, and so my role is first of all to make sure that every player is still motivated to play and is still happy in the club. So I do that by sending them random messages, such as, like, do you want to still, like, sorry, I see someone doesn't turn up for training, like, do you still want to play? Everything okay? So I've got to make sure I keep good contact with every single member of the team. But I have to organize the trainings to determine how many people go into training. And I have to organize that with my superiors, who are the treasurers and the vice president and president of the club. On the pitch, I have to kind of act as a leader because my role is as the captain.
Yeah, my part is basically, I just try to give advice. It's also because I have like 6 years of professional football in my background.
Professional?
Five professional, 6 in total.
I think I'm the only one who does like 1 hour ride every single time to come here for training. But like, I do it for the team because I do it for other lads who were playing with me. And yeah.
On the pitch, I obviously always try and give it my all. I have to get back into the game first a bit after being out for that long. But after that, I'd love to keep holding the midfield together and work very hard.
Well, for me, I think I'm a very motivated and can also be a very aggressive player. So my role would be, you know, to, I don't know, let's say in the 70th minute when it's 0-0 or something, or it's a close game, that I go in into a rough challenge and just motivate the team like that, you know? Oh my God. Just motivate the team like that, you know? With a... because if you're willing, if you see that you have teammates, you know, who are willing to give it all, then you yourself are willing to give it all as well most of the time.
My role since the beginning is I just want to bring the intensity in everything I do. I know that I don't have the technicality that many of the players have at the Plein, so I just try to bring the intensity and...
So right now I'm in the club's board, and my position is secretary. So I make the agendas for board meetings. I have to register all the club members
in the KNVB system and in their teams. And for the team, I just try to help out a bit tactically, finding the right members.
Oh, huge one, huge one. Like, you know, really, like, you know, like pounding, you know.
That's a bit weird.
No, I just, you know, regular, I reckon, like, you know, just a player. I like to not, you know, not start on the bench all the time, but I don't really mind it. I enjoy just coming to football, watching, play a bit, you know.
I always try not to give myself a role of a leader, but I always try to help people out. So maybe people maybe more shy, who have more difficulties in relate with the other players. I always try to bond the team. I always try to put effort in, in keep the team up also in during difficulties.
That team. I think personally for me, I think obviously I have this role at the moment of making this documentary and just trying to like, well, do all of this stuff. But then I also feel like I've got a bit of a role just to try and just make sure people enjoy themselves. With regards to just the more like mundane stuff, just try and be someone that's like easy to be around, smiling, friendly, having a good time. Like, yeah, that's it. What's going down? What's going down?
So how's the session going?
Mighty well. It was fucking beeping. Shut up! Oh, I can't believe it.
I'm back. Back again in position as usual, guys. Nice. Come back.
Got space. Use the space. You're fast. You're fast. Yeah. You're fast. Use it. Use it.
Yeah, in the middle with three. Adia.
Gabba, how's the session going?
What?
How's the session going?
It's difficult, man. It's tough. No balls because tough defense, man. We're gonna win it.
What are your thoughts on the seven players who have been selected for the cup?
My thoughts are that I think they all deserve. I mean, obviously it's hard to make choices. I'd say if it was me, I'd put everyone, but then, you know, we can't do that. So it's the same as in picking the 11 starters. It's all great. Everyone, they're all great guys. So it's tough to choose, but the seven that are there have it. They completely deserve it.
There's some great players in there, and it's almost like you look at them and then you look at the players who weren't selected and you think, well, you've got to select them, but you know that you can't because the squad depth now is so good in the Plein.
There's not all the best players because we have to tailor like positions and shit, you know. There's no point in putting all our strikers or all our defensive players, you know. But I think the players chosen are definitely like, I feel like every player chosen deserves it because like we've been the most active.
Before the game, he's getting his good stuff. He's got, what's that?
First time I find apple juice in the Netherlands. It's pretty neat.
And he got himself some bananas. And he got himself a sausage roll.
What's my...
Woo!
Right. Hello, sir.
Morning, lad.
Here we are.
You
good? Sweating from the bike ride, man.
Yeah.
Fucking hell. Guys, already on it.
Yeah, I'm not gonna ask any of your food. I haven't eaten.
He's getting ready. He's getting ready. He's getting ready.
I have 11.
Oh, okay.
So we
go.
Yeah,
pre-cup game, first game of the season, Paolo, how are you feeling?
Kick off in,
I'm all right,
2 hours.
I went to sleep at 4 and I woke up at 10. And I was drunk. And drunk. Yeah, I'm all right, to be honest. I'm excited.
At what time did you have pasta last night?
4:30.
At 4:30?
Yeah, I had a kebab at 4. I rolled the joint, I did 2 puffs, I was so tired, I said like...
No, so dry. Did you sleep with your clothes on? You usually do that.
Okay, last year,
every night, time you went to sleep,
Paolo goes to sleep and I went to get a lighter in his room. Sorry, hello. How is bro? Paolo on his bed, on his cover.
Literally
like,
shoes.
Joint, like, the joint is just right there.
Shoes.
He's like sleeping.
Shoes, sweater, everything.
Bro, you got it the night, you know. You're tired.
That's not the problem.
But you don't even take your shoes off.
Then at
5 a.m.
we wake up, take everything off.
Exactly.
Look. Some people don't understand me, you know. Like, never in my life.
He's been. Disco. Come to my disco.
Feeling today?
Pressure before the game. We gotta win this, we gotta be a war man. We don't like to lose war.
We're here.
Are we playing on this pitch?
Yeah, we're here.
This is
to be honest, this is a bit professional for me.
They have the facilities.
They actually have a changing room.
Tiger bomb. Okay, gentlemen, we've got half an hour. Let's get a good warm-up outside. All right. After the warm-up, we'll come back in here quickly. Have a 5-10 minute chat before we go out. We'll do the starting lineup and then we'll get straight into the game. All right. So let's have a good warm-up. Stretch nicely, guys. It is.
Very excited for this game, first game of the season. Got the best player standing next to me over there.
Mm-hmm. That is correct. The only reason why we come to these games, isn't it?
Malik, chilling. Give me a spit.
Okay, so the game is underway here.
Right, straight into it, are we?
Graf playing with the ball, going down the right wing. Here comes number 13. 13's driving. Abbe's gone out to meet him, but Luke says not today.
The shifty touch. Passes it. Up.
So over the top.
Up to who? Oh, to Sebastian. Oh, the defender slipped and broke his ankle. Jonathan.
Jonathan's got it. Ooh, didn't quite get it to the striker there.
Ball's kicked but away.
But here we go. Here comes Graf again. Oh, a little dink there by the little South African.
Abbe is in the wind. He's gonna run back, come on. Who's on the defender right now?
That's Luke Verhagen. Oh, he's been beaten, but he takes the man down.
Solid for Luke.
Here comes the free kick. I'm not entirely sure what he was doing there, folks, but okay.
He's kicked it back in, what's gonna happen? And
that
really
is a masterclass on how not to take a free kick, folks. There's
Arthur
De Moubray.
Looking kinda lost. Oh. Touches the ball, he's excited. Oh, what a kick.
Wasn't quite still, but you know, it's Sunday League, we'll keep playing.
Luke.
Even with me, the ref, the ref was accusing me of playing the ball while it was already rolling and not stopping before. He was so petty.
What?
You know how like, for goal kicks, the ball has to stop before you take it.
Yeah?
But sometimes when like, Albert throws the ball to me, I control it. And then Paul said, the ref went and said, oh, no, you're not allowed to do that.
You know, don't put this on record, but like, I was definitely like calling offsides that were not offside. I was just like, yeah, offside. Yeah, don't put it on the record, because it ain't very professional. But I was like, the dude was like dangerous. I was like, yeah, offside. And the referee, he didn't even question, no one questioned it. I saw the dude like who was like, who I called offside. He was like, no, I was not offside. I told him, hey.
Which player should we look out for this game?
I would say... I'm just striking him. Savvy, very strong guy. I like him.
Yeah. Do you think they got good prospects of winning this match?
I think so. Look at this. I mean, it looks solid. I think it's beautiful.
Beautiful. Beautiful game.
playing again. Oh, we played it through. He's played it through. This is it. Surely to make 1-0. Oh, what a save by the keeper. What a save. Get it out.
Now who's it? Now Carl's driving it down. Carl's driving it down. Jonathan's driving. Jonathan's driving.
That wasn't raising his hand. Cross it.
Oh. Aww. He's gone for the shot. He makes it through. What a ball. Unlucky there was a defender in the way. But Gabo keeps fighting.
Oh, he keeps the ball. He's going to cross it in or is he going to shoot? What is Gabo going to do?
Oh, he's hit the post. He's hit the post. Oh. Level of football. The pressure. Oh, he's again. Gabo shot. Oh. The keeper's legs.
Well, for me, really would have changed the game. Then, once again, hit the post in the 15-minute post. Like, it's a question of centimeters. It goes a few centimeters and it's a goal, and that does change the game.
Oh, he's played over the top! He's played over the top! Number seven goes to the DK! Oh, what a shocker! Here we have half time there with a bit of an Alistair Bousquet on the side.
Where did that come from? I mean, we didn't have much to do, I don't think, so that's always a good sign.
Yeah, that is a good sign.
I think we should have done more when we were 11 versus 10, but apart from that, I think we should continue like that. I'll go see the
players.
It shouldn't have been 0-0, to be honest. I think the first half was ours. We did not put our chances in.
Half time, 0-0. Both teams had chances. Both maybe could have had one apiece, but Arthur kept us in the game a bit.
He put some in the midfield. Janos and Mark are going to come in the center of the midfield now. Okay? Give that a bit of stability. Alex, you're going to be on the right side of midfield. Okay? On the left, Luca. Okay. Up and down those wings. Right, up and down the wing. Up front, okay? Jonathan, you're going to stay on. Cole is going to support you now. Okay. Cole's going to be the link between the centre midfield and Jonathan. Focus. Just keep focused. Let the ball do it. Get the ball around. Move it around the pitch early. Okay, don't hold the ball too long. Because you're going to get caught with it.
And my ankle's not doing the best, but we'll manage. We'll survive.
Do you know the first Plein game I went to, someone also hurt their ankle? Really? Yeah.
No, I think it's actually...
Second half is underway now. Graf playing it down pitch. Oh, it's a great ball. Defender's been turned. Oh, no, Luke's got a shocker. Can he finish his dinner, though? Can he finish his dinner? He can. He can. What a strike. What a strike. Keeper left. Well, starstruck there. Not much he can do, really. He's just taken that first time and said, you know what, I'm putting you bottom bins.
Almost kind of everywhere. The midfield was just a fucking big gaping hole. Everyone in the midfield was just on holiday, my guy. I was right back, bro. I was in the middle, bro. I was in the middle. I don't know if it's like middle.
Yeah, they're playing around the back. Oh, Abbe. Oh, no, it's not Abbe. It's someone. Oh, what a save by Arthur De Moubray. He tips it over the top of the bar. What a player. Graf now booting it down the pitch. Oh no, oh no, Arthur, what's he done? The keeper!
Where's the keeper?
The keeper's had a shocker. The keeper, been the best player all game, and now he's been left wondering, what if...
The keeper was in the bushes there, to be fair. Look at that. The player, no ease running around him, and a cheeky shot was all it took. Oh my...
And yeah, goalkeeper was on point. We appreciate Arthur for that thing.
Right? Well, that's, but, I mean, it happens, and it's not like... You know, it wasn't like a game. For me, it wasn't a game-changing mistake. It wasn't. As in, if you ask honestly, did we lose because of that mistake? Absolutely not. No.
Right, but I want you to see what he's been doing. Okay, so what I've told him to do is the two centre backs at the back. He's gonna sit between. Okay? He's gonna keep trying to stretch it. He's gonna keep on walking across the line all the time, making those runs across the line. Like,
there to Paolo Masiello, the Italian magista. Oh, plays it through, then to Luca, then on to Gabo.
What a play.
Now they're driving, Gabo driving, like a Ferrari from Italy, driving down the left wing. There he goes, driving, driving, driving. Can he get the ball in the box? He's put it in the air. Oh!
What a miss that was from Sebastian Wright.
When that ball comes up to me for the header, I thought I had it. It was just a bit too high. I didn't quite get up enough. Tried to put my head to it, and it misses a post by like this much. That was a tough one, a very tough one. But yeah, it happens. But here come Graf again, going down the right wing. They put something in the mixer. Oh no, Alistair Bousquet.
No.
Oh, he's finished.
Shifty touch.
Oh no, Alistair Bousquet.
I also personally kind of fucked it for Arthur, but we were already losing. It was the end of the game, so my goal really didn't really count, you know.
Now we have full time, folks. Full times. Alistair's giving a clap, saying, "You know what? That last goal didn't bother me."
Saying, "Well, half of the team wasn't ours, We also have, like, you know, some Danis in the team that, you know, sometimes, you know, they're kind of slow, kind of doing stuff, you know. But
names.
But no, I'm not gonna say names, bro. I'm not thinking of anyone in particular. I'm just saying, you know.
It's gonna be a tough one.
How do you feel about getting injured so early on in the game?
It's always tough.
Always
sad,
tough.
Sad times.
Oh. How do you feel about the first flying game?
A bit disappointing, you know. We could have had it, but we missed a few chances. Could have been better, but I think the boys gave it all, you know.
They're going to redeem themselves next week?
Yeah, for sure. Kind of got them back stronger, and we got it.
In the second half, we got a bit, I don't know, maybe a lack of stamina. They were beating us in their runs. They were passing balls over our defence and always getting them runs, and they ended up bagging 3 goals. And yeah, I mean, at the end of the day, when you look at it, it's not such a bad performance. So yeah,
it was a good first half.
Elias,
first half was good, second half was shit. I mean, if the ref gave the penalty, it would be a different score.
We've got to rewatch the footage. Sure.
How's the game today? Talk about it.
The game was pretty nice, honestly, to be fair. First game, we have a team of eclectic players, you know, a bit from everywhere, you know, different backgrounds. And I think we played decent for the team we had. Huh? Chemistry was not at its best, of course. But, you know, fuck it, you know, we had fun. That's all that matters. And yeah, I appreciated it.
This is my thought, man. Smashing the beer, man.
We played a good match. We got unlucky also with some opportunity that we wasted. But next week, are we recording? Ah, okay, sorry. Next week we're gonna
win it.
Win it because we practice, and unfortunately Elias got injured.
You've been injured. Talk us through it.
15th minute of the game. Rolled my ankle. Not much more else to say, to be honest.
How long's the road to recovery looking?
At this point, we don't know, but make it 2-3 weeks, we'll be back.
I think no one should be harsh on themselves and say, like, yeah, I missed. At the end of the day, it's first game of the season.
But the league's the only thing I really care about. And so, to be honest, as long as we're winning league games, I couldn't care about the cup.
That's good.
Yeah.
Any more questions, Alistair, though?
No.
Sweet.
She wakes up early every morning just to do her hair now, because she cares, y'all. Her day I wouldn't be right without her makeup. She's never had a makeup. She's just like you and me.
She's hopeless. La 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 la